Hello friends, welcome to the worksheet series. Alright, today we are going to discuss about chapter number 4. This worksheet series is very helpful in solving the case studies in board exam. So you people, please see this full video, and this video will be check your understanding about this chapter and different concepts. Alright, so let's start the worksheet. Now first is a fill in the blank. Dash seeks to bridge the gap between where we are and where we want to go. Alright, so it is talking about present and future. So what is a bridge between present and future? That is none other than planning. Okay, so next question is like this. Identify the feature of planning from the following statements. So some statements are given, and on the basis of that you have to find out the feature. This statement is talking about which feature of planning that they are talking. So let's start with the first one. Planning is not an exclusive function of top management nor of any particular department, but the scope of planning differs at different level and among the different departments. So this statement is talking about that planning is everywhere. That means it is all pervasive. Next, all other managerial functions are performed within the framework of plans drawn. Alright, so other functions are like organizing is there, staffing is there, directing is there, controlling is there. So this is a primary function, this is a first function of management. Alright, afterwards other functions are on this base of this planning, other functions are performed. Next, planning is essentially involve the choice among the various alternative and activities. Alright, so different alternatives are there. To do any work we have different alternatives, and out of which we have to select one of them. So it is what we can say, it is helping in it decision making. So it is facilitating decision making. So in planning is nothing but it is a one of the decision making activity, we can say, because we are taking decision regarding different options. Next is planning requires application of mind, involve foresight, intelligent imagination and sound judgment. So it is talking about what planning is nothing but it is mental exercise. Next is planning is framed, it is implemented and it is followed by another plan and so on. So here they are talking about planning is what? Planning is a continuous activity. It is not stop at one. Once you have done the plan, afterwards you don't have to do anything. It is not like that. You have to do the planning on continuous basis, because planning process is like what? One, it is framed, it is implemented, followed by another plan. So it is continuous process. Next, planning has no meaning unless it contributes to the achievement of predetermined organizational goals. Alright, so what we can say regarding this planning has no meaning. That means it is focusing on organizational objective, on achievement of organizational objective. So we can say like that, it is focusing on organizational objectives. Planning requires logical and systematic thinking rather than guesswork or wishful thinking. Alright, so here no guessing is there, no wishful activity is there. Why? Because it is mental exercise. Alright, so after logical thinking only we are applying this. Next, planning requires at all level of management as well as all the departments of the organization. That means it is also everywhere, we can say it is a pervasive activity. Next, the various functions of management are interrelated and equally important. However, planning provides the basis for all other functions. Again, they are trying to tell that it is a primary function of management. It is a first function of management on which other functions are based. Alright, so first was there, it was talking about the features of planning. Okay, now let's move for the next, that is talking about limitation of planning. So identify the limitation of planning from following statements. Alright, so from the statements we have to talk about which limitation they are talking about. Let's see the first one. It becomes difficult to accurately assess future trends in environment. Planning cannot foresee everything, and thus there may be obstacles of effective planning. So what they are talking about, they are talking about that accurately we cannot say what is going to happen in the future. So they are talking about it may not work in dynamic environment. What they are trying to say, planning may not work in dynamic environment, because we know that the environment is continuously, it is dynamic, it is changing politically, it's changed socially, it is changing. Some legal matters are there, some economic matters are there, so it is continuously changing. So we cannot say accurately what is going to happen in future. So it may not work in dynamic environment, we can say like this. Next, sometimes plans to be drawn up take so much of time and that there is not much time left for their implementation. So what they are talking about, planning is a lengthy process. You have to collect the information, you have to analyze it, and then you have to predict the future. So you can say it is a time consuming activity. It is not done in one night. It will take time. Next, managers have a tendency to rally on previously tried and tested successful plans. It is not always true that just because plan has worked before, it will be work again. Alright, so last year what was successfully done, this year same cannot be happen again. Alright, so if you are following the last year plan, it does not give any guarantee of success. Remember what here they are talking about. Previously it was succeed, but this year it will mean there is a chance it will not work again also. So it does not guarantee of success. We can say it does not guarantee of success. Alright, so when you are planning, it doesn't mean you are getting the success only. So why? Because previously what you are doing, it doesn't mean you are going to get the same result again. So it does not guarantee success. Next, when plans are drawn, huge cost is involved in their formulation, and sometimes cost involved is more than benefit derived. Alright, so that means here you have to compare the cost and benefits. Alright, because when you are planning, you have to do many things. So that's why we can say it is a costly activity, you can say like this. It is a costly. Next, in an organization, a well-defined plan is drawn up, which then decide the future course of action, and manager may not be in the position to change it. Alright, because plan is an activity done by the top management, so middle level management, they have to just follow it. Alright, sometimes they are not in position to change it. So it's a, you can say it is a rigid activity. Rigidity is there in planning. There is a rigidity. Next, planning is done by the top management, and people working at other levels of management are not allowed to give their ideas. Alright, so it is reducing creativity. It reduces the creativity. Why? Because once plan is done, you just have to follow it. You are not able to change. You are not allowed to change actually. Alright. Now the next one is identify the step, identify step in the process of planning from following statements and also number them. Alright, so we have to give the number, step number, and identify which step is it is. Alright, let's see one after one. First is, once the plans are developed, they are put into action. Alright, so what they are talking about, they are talking about put into action. Action will start, that means they are talking about implementation. Implementation of planning, and from where implementation will start, it is a 6-step of planning. Next, to see whether plans are being implemented, activities are performed according to schedule, a proper check is required. Proper check is required. That is a last function of last function of planning process, that is follow-up action. So whenever plan is that it is implemented, you must have to take the follow-up, otherwise it is not completed. So it is a last step of process, planning process, that is follow-up action. Next, on the basis of merits, demerits, resources and consequences, the best plan has to be adopted, which must be the most feasible, profitable and with best negative consequences. It is not best, it is least negative. Least negative consequences. So what they are talking about here, they are talking about selecting an alternative, because we have many options, so you have to select an alternative from many. So they are talking about selecting an alternative. So this selecting an alternative is a 5th step in the process. Next, manager has to make certain assumptions relating to future conditions. Alright, on the basis of which our plan is based. Alright, so they are talking about developing premises. Developing premises, and it is a 2nd step of planning. 2nd step. Next, manager has to, next is all the alternative course of action is to achieve the objective should be identified. Alright, so whenever you are, we want to do something, there are many options, different options are there, different alternatives are there, that you have to identify here. So it is identifying different alternatives. Alright, so it is a 3rd step in planning process, identifying different alternatives. Next, manager has to identify and set up of objective which should be measured, understandable, clear and attainable. So whatever you are doing here, it should be, the objective should be measurable, understandable, clear, and this is the 1st step of planning, that is a setting organizational goals, setting objectives. All right so whenever you are setting objective, this is the 1st step of planning. So it should be like all the qualities should be there. Next, manager make a list of alternatives through which organization can achieve its objective, as there can be many ways to achieve the objectives and manager must know all of them. Alright, so here they are trying to say that you have to, manager say make a list. Alright, then what they have to do, objective. So here they are talking about evaluation, evaluating different course of action. Alright, and it is number 4, 4th step in planning process. Let's move for the next. It is identify the point of importance of planning from following statements. So here different points are given on the basis of which we have to identify which type of importance they are talking about. Let's move on question now. Planning helps the manager to look into the future and make the choice among the various alternative course of action. Alright, so here what they are talking about, the first one is there, it is about importance. Manager look into future and make the choice. So decision they have to take, so it facilitate decision making. So here you have to take the decision. Next, If goals are well defined, employees are aware of what the organization has to do and what they must do to achieve those goals. So everybody knows what they have to do very well. So it is providing direction. It provides direction. When everybody is clear what is about their performance, about their duties, about their authorities, it is easy to direct. Alright, so direction is there. So it provides direction. Planning is provide direction. Next, by deciding in advance the task to be performed, planning shows the way to deal with changes and uncertain events. Alright, what they are talking about? They are talking about that when we do the plan, it will reduce the risk of uncertainty. So it will reduce the risk. Reduces the risk of uncertainty. Next, planning provides the goals or standards against which actual performance is measured. So what they are talking about? They are talking about that it is establishes standard for controlling. So when we are doing planning, we are establishing standards for the controlling. Next, since planning ensures clarity in the thought and action, useless and redundant activities are minimized or eliminated. So here what they are talking about, redundant means unnecessary activities or wasteful activities are reduced or it is eliminated. So what they are talking about, it is talking about reducing overlapping of activity or some wasteful activity are there. So it is minimized or it is eliminated through the planning. Next is changes or events cannot be eliminated, but they can be anticipated or managerial response to them can be developed. So what they are talking about here, they are talking about, it is also again the same point is coming. We cannot eliminate anything, but we can just reduce. So same point will come, it is reducing the risk of uncertainty. Alright, so just reducing risk, it is not removing the risk, but it is reducing the risk. Let's move on the next. It is one of the plan specially designed to achieve particular goal that once achieved will not recur in the future. Such plan is developed to meet the needs of a unique situation. So which type of plan it is talking about? The question pattern is changed here. I think they are talking about not recur. That means they are talking about single use plan. Single use plan they are talking about. Next, these type of plans use over and over again because they focus on organizational situation that occur repeatedly. Alright, repeatedly occur, that means they are talking about standing plans. Standing plan and single use plan. Next, name four standing plans. Alright, four standing plans are there. Which are they? We know that policies, then procedures, then methods and rules. Alright, these plans are repeatedly used. Once it is made, it is used over and over again. Next, name three single use plan. Alright, single use plan we have, one is a program, another is budget. Alright, this is in our syllabus, so two we are writing here. Next, name two plans which are neither single use plans nor standing plans. They are not categorized in any plan like standing, it is not standing plan also, it is not single use also. We know very well it is none other than objectives and strategy. They are not part of any planning. We cannot say it is a standing plan or it is a single use plan. Okay, let's move on. Next is here like this. Question number 11. Identify the type of plan from following definitions. So definitions are given on the basis of which we have to identify the type of plan. Remember, from the planning chapter, most of the time the case study is asked from the type of plans. So these concepts must be clear in every student's mind, because it is very helpful in solving case studies. Let's see the first one. Identify the series of related tasks that make up the chronological sequence and established way of performing work to be accomplished. Alright, so series of related work is given. Procedure. In procedure, the series of work in chronological order it is set. Alright, first what you have to do, next what you have to do, like this. Next, it is a statement of expected results. Result expressed in numerical terms and for definite period of time in the future. Alright. So none other than when we are talking about numerical terms, it is budget. Next, it is a plan containing detailed statement about the project outlining the objective, policy, procedure, rule, task, physical and human resources required to implement any course of action. Alright, detailed statement. Whenever this word is coming, detailed statement, understand it is none other than program. Next, they may be designed as a desired future position that management would like to reach. Alright, so it is none other than objectives where management wants to reach. Next, it refers to the general guideline which bringing uniformity in decision making and for the achievement of organizational objectives. Alright, so general guideline. When general guideline is here coming, it is none other than policy. Alright, general guideline to bring uniformity in decision making. So it is policy. Next is they are a specific statement that tell us what is to be done and what not to be done in a specified situation. So it is a rule. So specific statement. Next is they are standardized way or manners in which particular task has to be performed. Particular task, alright, they are talking about one task, that means it is talking about method. Next, it refers to those plans which an organization prepare to face various situations, threats and opportunities posed by the environment. Alright, so here they are talking about plans, those plans, that means they are talking about strategy. Alright, so whenever they are prepared, when plans are prepared, which an organization prepare the faces, situation, threats, opportunity and environment. So here it is a comprehensive plan. So they are talking about strategy. Alright, now we are reaching to the last one. But the question is again, the situations are given, but we have to, here they are talking about definitions. Now the situations are given from which we have to identify the type of plan. Identify the different type of plan from the following examples are there. First one is increasing mobile users by 25% in future. So that what this is objective they are talking about. Alright, objectives. Clearly mentioned 25% in 3 years. Timing is also given. Next, Batra Limited decides to advertise their product on TV and radio. So they have decided, that means they are talking about strategy. They have made a strategy to do advertisement on TV as well as on radio. Offering 25% jobs to women. Alright, so that policy they have make, that this we are going to follow. Next, smoking not permitted within factory premises. Alright, this is a rule, anybody can say easily, it is a rule. Varun Electronics decides to sell TV sets through exchange old television sets. Alright, the exchange policy is there. They have decided to do this. It is a part of strategy. Next, no admission to student getting less than 80%. So this policy they may have done. Policy is decided that we are not going to do give admission. An employee will be selected through an interview after written test. Alright, this policy they have made, this policy of selection. A detailed plan for construction of shopping mall. Alright, so shopping mall involves many things, so it is programmed. Because detailed plan is there. Next, Bright Industry has decided to make all payments above 50,000 rupee by check. Alright, so we can say it is a policy. We are following this policy. Next, only 10 leaves are allowed to employees during 1 year. So it is a part of policy. The policy they have to follow everyone. Next, R Limited decides that higher level orientation program at lower level apprenticeship training to be provided. That is they are talking about method. What they are talking about, for the higher level orientation program will be there, and for the lower level training will be there, apprenticeship training will be there. So both are working at different level, so they will be provided, training will be also given by different method only. Alright, so they are talking about method. So this video is completed. I am giving this giving the PDF file of this paper in the description, so you can download it and you can solve this at home also, and you can share with this your friends also. Thank you very much.